Hi, hello guys. Welcome to Web Development for Kids and Teens. Yeah, I think this is the 8th lecture of video, right? So I hope you guys are having fun learning, you know, and you actually remember everything that you are learning, all right? Because yeah, the point is to have fun, learn, you know, and to use this skill in the future, okay? So we've come a long way, right? So we've learned so many things so far, right? And we're able to do like so many web pages, like 10 or more, right? And currently we are working on our personal web page, right? You know, so we're able to work on the home page, right? So I want to assume that you guys have something like this. Then we have the about me, right? So today we want to work on my project page, right? So I asked you guys to have a sketch of how you want your my project page to be, right? So I hope that you guys have something on paper, right? Okay, so but my project page is just a place where you show some website that you've worked on, right? So yeah, that is live, that meaning live, that people can go to Google and search for it, right? So since we don't have any yet, we are just gonna have placeholder, right? Just dummy content, right? But yeah, so then in future when you have more project, then you can go and put it there, right? So but I did my own sketch, right? So this is like, yeah, don't mind my drawing. Yeah, I did it like very fast, right? So I want to display 6 projects on my page, right? 3 for each row, right? Then now for this box, I'm gonna put image, then under here I will put the name of the project, then I will have another picture, project name, all right? So so now this will guide me, you know, on how to write my code, right? You guys, you might be looking at this that, oh yeah, this we can use table for this. Yes, you are right, you can use table because this is row, right? Then this is column, right? I can use table for it, but I can also use something else for it, right? So I can use div for it, right? So I will show you guys how to use div to do something like this, okay? So let's start writing code. All right, but that's why we're here, okay? So we need to create my project HTML file, right? That's the thing that we need to do, okay? So then we'll create a file. Make sure that you don't create the file inside CSS or inside this IM, so the file should be outside here. All right, so right there, so let's call it myproject.html. So if you're able to do this, that means you're a genius already. So many people don't know how to create HTML file, but that's the first thing, right? So then you see that we probably need this header like this, right? Just change the content, right? So that means we need to copy code from about me. So let's just copy everything, then we remove things that we don't need. So let's just paste it, right? So what we don't need is, see, so we only need the navigation, right? So we don't need that profile picture, then we don't need all of these, right? All of this, we don't need all of that, okay? So let's see. Okay, yeah, but before we do that, so from index, you know, before my project is pointing to friend, so let's change that to my project, okay, right there. So that's for index. Then under about me too, you need to change it, my project. Then the one that I just copied to my project, so you need to change it to my project, okay, good. So now we go to home, we refresh that, Then when I go to my project, you see, so it shows us this navigation. Now we need to populate this to look something like this. Okay, so the first thing that I will do is, you know, this this body is for body about. I mean, we can leave it, but let's just change it. So now let's say body project. That's the class for body project. Then we'll go to our CSS. So where do we have the body about? Where is it? So this one. So just make a copy of this. Then we'll call it body project. Okay, so that's the first thing to do. Okay, so that won't change anything. But now, so let's just start filling up things in here. So the first thing that I'll do is, again, div. Div is everything that we need to work on. So div. So this div is what is going to, the div we house everything, right? Then I need another div for each row. Okay, so this is div for row one, right? Then this is the div for row two. Okay, so this div is the parent, this one is row one, row two. See, there's a div that is around everything. There's a div for this row, there's a div for this row. Okay, good. So now the div that is up here, so let's call it, let's give it a class and call the class row. Okay, the parent div. Then that class row, just put this in here. Class row, say clear both. Just put this. I'll explain what this does later. So just do this, right? That's for that one. Then for this first row, let's give it a class of column. Okay. So now let's define our column in our CSS, okay? Column. Float left. Width 33.33%. I will explain this in a second. Then margin top 3 em. Now let's use 8 em. Okay, 8 em. All right. So you see, this column is a first column, right? This is a first column. So wait, let me see. I think, yeah, so like this is the first column. Wait, so we have this div 1, 2, 3. So I think for each of these we need 3 of. Okay, so let's just continue. So like what this does actually, right? This float left, right? Because when I have this here, this first picture, right? If I put the next picture, it will just put it on the next line. It won't allow this to stay here, right? So but when I say tell this one to float left, so it means that move to the left and allow something else to come here. Okay, so that's what this float left means, right? So then then the width of that 3.3, right? So since I have three pictures in here, so the width for all of them is 100%, then I want to divide the width by three pictures, right? So 100 divided by 3 is 33.3, right? So this takes 33.3, 33.3, 33.3, okay? Then the margin top is just to put some space up here. So now this clear boat, this clear is used to clear float left, right? Because now I have float left for this, float left for this, float left for this. But this one, I want it to be on a new line. I don't want it to also float left out to this row, right? So this means that clear this float left and start on a new line, okay? That's what this clear boat means, okay? So now let me see. Okay, so I think I actually need more of this, but let's just take it one after the other. So this is column, right? Then we are gonna have like image here. So but let's go and get our images, okay? So let me see. So to get the images, remember we're gonna use FreePix, okay? So remember to click on borders and remember to click on free. So what we want to search for, just search for website project image, right? So search for that. Why is it not bringing anything up? Let me see. Just go to freepik.com. Okay, so let's search for that website project image. So don't forget to click on borders and click on free. Okay, so we just need something like this. So but I want you to get download images that have this kind of size. So you can download this. So we need six. Download this one, this one, this one. Don't download something that is large like this. So something that, yeah, that look like this, right? Maybe something like this. Don't download something as long as this, something like this, right? So download six of these. Something like this, okay? So again, when I was downloading it, I think that there's a limit to the number of images that you can download every day. So if you're able to download three or four, just keep it, right? Then you can duplicate that image on your website. Then maybe the next day you can come here again and download more, all right? But so I downloaded all my images already, okay? So and they are right in here. Let me show you. So see, these are all my projects. So I call this one project one. Project, this is supposed to be project, right? So let me even rename it. So this is supposed to be project five. So you download everything, rename it, put it in this part, okay? This is supposed to be what? Project two, okay. Project two. Project 3, project 4, project 6. Okay, so we have all the images right there. Okay, so yeah, so again, if you're unable to download all the images, just download maybe as many as possible, maybe 3, then you can duplicate it for your cards, right? So if you're able to download three, so you can use the same picture here and the same picture here, right? Then you can change it later. So, but let's go. So now for this first one, let's do this first one. So let's call it IMG. So SRC, if you remember, IMG, oops, IMG, then I need project one, right? Project one. I want to give it a width of 90%. 90%. Then don't forget our alt message. Call just say project one image, right? Then we close this. Good. Okay. So let's see how that looks. Okay. Right there, it's really cool, just right there. Okay, so then you remember we also need something down here. Okay, just the name of the project. So let's come here, let's use a paragraph for that. So let's say this is my first project. I mean, it's supposed to be the name of your project, maybe like website for my school or something like that. Yeah, but again, this is just, you know, like a placeholder, right? So then I actually want to change the color of this. So let's give this a class too. So let's call it project info. All right, project underscore info. Again, you can call the name of your CSS class anything that you want. Okay, you don't have to follow my, right? So, but yeah, so I just choose this because I want to. So project info, so that project info is just, I just give it a color and a font size, that's all, right? So project info, that's that right there. So let's see how that this looks. See, this is my first project. Very good. So now we need this and this now. So that should be easy. That should just be copy and paste, but be very careful. So we just need to copy this two times, right? One and two. I want it to be on a straight line. Okay, so the only thing I need to change, so my project, so this image project two, then it should be project three. All right, then I'll change this. This is my second project. This is my third project. All right, so let's see what we get. There you go. See, very easy. My first project, second project, third project, right? So we have that on this line. All right, so again, so like, this actually, when you have your real project, this will just be a link. So when people click on this, it will not take them to that your project, right? But since we don't have anything, we just make it a placeholder, right? So that is that. So now we need this second row down here, right? So that's gonna change a little bit because we're gonna change the column. All right, we're gonna change something in the column, so we're gonna have another one, another column that says column two, because I don't want this space to be up to 8 em margin top, right? Yeah, I want 8 em, yeah, but I don't want 8 em, yeah, so that's why I'll create another column class and I'll call it column two. Okay, column two, then the only thing I need to change is I want this to be 2 em, right? So now when I'm creating for this second row, which is gonna be down here, so let's see, so this div, okay, let me just copy and paste this. So three times. One, two, three. can call it this one. Second row. Start here. Alright. So this is 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Then you can say. Here, all right, and again, remember I said that this is going to be column 2, column 2, and column 2. All right, let me see. Oh no, yeah, so I think I had a mistake there. Yeah, I was also confused. So yeah, this will probably this is not gonna be here at all. Sorry about that. Yeah, I was confused. Yeah, so the second row is supposed to be like this old thing right here. Yeah, sorry about that. Okay, so this everything like this, then copy. Yeah, so then what you have to do is to do this and do this, then probably don't need this comment, but it's fine. Right, then we'll do project 4 project 5 project 6. Please don't be confused. Okay, yeah, I the other one that I did was a mistake, right? So this is how it's supposed to be. Yeah, so then change all the alt messages. This is supposed to be 2, 3, then it's supposed to be 4, it's supposed to be 5, and it's supposed to be 6. Okay, let's see if everything looks good. Project 4, project 5, project 6. So then we'll do this. This is my fourth project. This is my fifth project, and this is my sixth project. Okay, I think this looks good. Should work. I just say second row. Start here. All right. So let's see if that works out. Yeah, it does. Okay, cool. So yeah, I see it's very easy. All right, so I mean, not that easy, but yeah, hopefully you guys get it right. So we just have the first row here, and we did that using this div first row. So the first row has three divs, or you can call it cards, three cards, right? You know, for each card you have your image and you have your paragraph right in here. So yeah, and I think this space is still too much, right? Let's try to adjust it from here. I think it's this one, column 2. Let's give it 1.5 pm. Okay, yeah, it's closed up a little bit. Okay, yeah, again, so people should generally be able to click on this link, right? So this is supposed to be a link. All right, so but yeah, like since we don't have the project already, so, and then you can give it any name, right? You can call it this one, oh, my game projects, my any kind of project that you want to call it, right? It's just a placeholder, like I said, you know. So so I think that's that for the project page, I guess. So I'm thinking of some other thing that we could do to this, but I think this looks good for now, right? So if you have more projects, you just have more of this, right? So if you want to do three rows, right, or four rows or five rows, just copy this duplicate it down there, down here. Okay, let me just remove this. Then you just look for the images, right, to put, and images to put in here. Then you give it a name, and then it should be good, right? So, all right. So I hope you guys enjoy this. Yeah, this is probably short, but yeah. So next time we'll just create a video game page, right? Again, I want you guys to try and come up with a diagram of how you want your game page to be, right? And you can take a picture of it and put it in the comment section below, right? You know, just for me to see. Maybe I might like it and I might actually use it for the video games page that we are gonna have, right? You know, the video games page is just to show or like the video games that you play, the one that you like, why you like it, you know, maybe like a character that you like, and keep information about the character or something. Like, just, you know, just be creative, right? So if you want to do something like that, put it in the comment section, and I will maybe use it. Right, okay, so that's that for that. I hope you guys enjoy this video. Please like the video, right? And share the video with your friends. You know, if you have a friend in school that you think the person should also learn web development, tell them about it and show them cool thing that you've done. So like right now, like these web pages, you can only see it on your personal computer, right? You know, so but after we are done with video games and contact me page, I will show you guys how to actually deploy that to online, you know, so that people can actually use Google to check it from anywhere in the world, right? And I will show you how to host your website for free. So like they call it web hosting, right? You can host your website that people everywhere will see it. So that means you can be in your school and you type on your school computer, you know, then your website will come up, then you can show it to your friends and your teachers and all of that, right? But again, try to talk to people that you think that they should also learn from this, you know, and and let them know, okay? So yeah, that's that. I hope you guys have a nice weekend or a nice whatever day that it is. All right, okay guys, bye.